ahead and get started. Enjoy the play, Away in a Manger.
Away in a manger, no beautiful old day. The little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars of the bright sky lay down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. To stay close by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care, and fit us for heaven to live with thee there.
So, this is what you want me to tell them? The people, your people who have lived in dark exile all these many years with their backs up against some Babylonian wall. It was one thing when you had me tell the king that a virgin would give birth. Go back to sleep, my dear. I'm talking to God.
Is he listening?
What do you mean, is he listening?
Well, are you listening to him?
You see what I mean, Lord? Even my own wife questions me. Now, you are God Almighty. You do what you want to do. But you want me to tell the people that Messiah is going to be just some plain fellow like one of us? That he's going to suffer? He's going to die? Why not Moses to lead us out of exile? Or King David, the mighty warrior, not some tiny little... Where is the oil for the lamp?
It's where it always is.
This is what I'm talking about, Lord. We are a people in darkness, stumbling around, stubbing our toe on the sin of the world. We need a mighty rescuer. We need a savior, not some tiny little. Such a tiny flame, and the whole room is filled with light. I am a man of unclean lips. Forgive me, Lord. I will tell them what you have shown me, even if I don't understand it. I will trust you, good Lord, in your own good time to bring us Emmanuel, to bring us light and hope. Light and hope. I'm coming back to bed.
Your friends left in such a rush to go tell the world. I think that's how they put it. And what a thing to tell. Did you know an angel visited me too? It's true. And he said that my boy would be great. The Son of God. He said that he would be the King of Angels. The King of all. Do you think that they'll understand? Do you think that they'll come to worship him? Will they accept him? Just look around us. It's not exactly a palace, is it? Noisy animals. Hay, out of all things, for a bed. And that stench. For everything that he is. Maybe this isn't enough. I find myself just watching him. Adoring him. I thought I knew what love was. Until he came along. My mother gave this blanket to me when I was just a little girl. A gift of love. I wore it out. When we were preparing for the trip to Bethlehem, I told Joseph I wanted to bring it. No, he said. We must pack light. I brought it anyway. The baby needs a blanket. Yes, they will come. The faithful. How could they not? He was born the King of Angels. He will be great and mighty. He is all this and more. But when you go tell my young friend, Be sure to tell them that he is an incredible gift of love.
Shall come to thee, O Israel.
know. Rejoice, again I say rejoice. For unto us is born the Savior of the world. And so high, a living source of God. Help is on the way, and holy is the God. Rejoice, again I say rejoice. For us, rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, again I say rejoice. For unto us is born the Savior of the world. And take heart, O Israel. To help you God away. Rejoice, again I say rejoice. For unto us is born the Savior of the world. We're so divine, the help is out of your holy is of rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Shall come to thee, O Israel.
Don't worry, my boy. You'll be nice and warm. I wrapped you in your mother's old blanket. Some start we've had, huh? A 90-mile walk, just so you can get born in a stable. You know, if we were back home in Nazareth, oh, I could build you a fine crib. But here, no crib. I have to put you to sleep in the hay. Visit from an angel? Mm-hmm. Had to write it down so I wouldn't forget what it said. Joseph, son of David, fear not to take Mary for your wife. For what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will save the people from their sins. Did you hear that? You will save us from our sins. You are the Messiah. and I've been chosen to be the Messiah's papa. I do not know how it will happen, but I'm done doubting. I want to tell you how happy that you make me. No, it's more than happiness. It's, what did the shepherds say the angels told them? Oh, they bring good news. Great joy. Yes. That's what it is. It's joy. That's what you bring me. My sweet, beautiful boy. You bring me so much joy.
Oh, Sing for me.
Great light shines best in great darkness. That is a lesson we learned as we traveled many miles in the darkness of night. And I know. Nighttime is the most dangerous time to travel. However, there's a great degree of difficulty in following a star in the daylight. We were looking for royalty, but we had no idea what we were going to find, eh? I've been in the outer courts of princes and kings, noisy assemblages these, hangers-on on every corner, quarters of favor, making endless racket, scheming, chattering, everyone wanting an audience with nobility. And none of that here. No. Here, silence. Lingering, calm, awestruck silence. Here, a newborn, wrapped in cloths and lying in a feeding trough. There were two milk goats standing silently behind him. Chickens pecked on the ground. An exhausted woman and a humble man. And outside, shepherds. Shepherds timidly watching, and all are silent. We dare not say a word. We bow down. We worship. And we gently lay our gifts on the ground. I've spent the bulk of my days searching for the truth of it all. Trying to make sense of this life. But that search, it was different. That time, while we were searching, we were also being led, not merely by a star, but by the hand of Almighty God. He led us. He led us to the one in whom all truth rests. He led us to a child, a baby, a king.
Messiah.
was born. Run back, run to mother and child. Hold me if it's so tender and mine. Sleep and the sun and all my shepherds great at my side.
Kid, there was this one day I was troubled about something. I don't even remember what it was. My father noticed, and he comes over to me and he places his hands on my head. And he says, "Shalom, son. Do you know what that means?" Yes, I nodded. He said it meant peace. Then my daddy, he knelt beside me. And he took my face in his big, calloused shepherd's hands. He said, "Yes, peace, but more." And then he put a finger on my heart. And he said, "Shalom, God's highest and most complete good be upon you. That is my prayer. For you, my son." He left his staff with me, and I've looked for it what he mentioned? Shalom? All these years. When the angels came, there was no hint of wind, no clouds, just stars. So many stars. He showed himself to us suddenly. And there was an angel brighter than stars who spoke and said, "Do not be afraid. I have good news. Your Savior has... Your Savior has been born. And he lies in a manger. And then quiet, as if the whole world is waiting to breathe. A Savior, God's highest and most greatest good for us, for me. And then suddenly, multitudes of angels shattered the silence, saying, "Glory, glory, glory. God is on earth. His peace on earth. My Father's prayers I've seen. Finally, shalom, peace."
Band, go ahead and come on up. We're going to get ready to close. I know it was short and sweet, but who was blessed? I could just feel the Lord in the room on that. Definitely. He was pleased with that. It was, you know, such a blessing to just, I feel like it was more dramatic than anything, but just to be able to have them actually just play out what each person was going through. What a crazy time. What a crazy time. You know, what if the Lord came to you and said, "You're pregnant"? You'd be like, "What?" Especially if you're a guy. You guys do know the Holy Spirit can do what he wants. But what a blessing it is to just kind of feel the heart of those that were involved and actually saw it firsthand and felt what it felt like to be a part of it in real life, because it really did happen. It's not a made-up story. It's not a myth. And we felt like this was very simple, but we feel like it blessed the Lord, and with the music especially. Who can say amen to that? Was the music awesome? Very anointed. You guys can go ahead and stand. I'm gonna get ready to close, and we're gonna close with "Joy to the World." Woohoo! But before we close, I just wanted to remind you. I felt like the Lord wanted me to remind you of the word that He gave me at the Christmas bash. As you're going into 2020. And he said, for those of you who didn't hear the word, if you are not at the Christmas bash, this is what the word was. He said, there are those who have felt many losses. You have felt loss. Maybe over this 2019, you've lost things. Maybe you've lost relationships. Maybe you've lost a job. Maybe you've lost life. Maybe you've lost children. Maybe you've lost loved ones. And you have been feeling the pain of the loss. And the Lord said, when I gave the word at the Christmas bash, that there are those in 2019, you have felt loss. You have felt the losses, whatever they were. That it could be many things. You have felt loss. And you feel like you're going to continue losing. That's all your life has is loss. Things are going to keep going wrong. How many more things can go wrong? Yeah, never ask that, she says. But the Lord wanted me to tell you, if you're in this room and you were not there and you didn't get this word at the Christmas bash, the Lord wants me to let you know, you will see the gains. And that was the biggest part when he gave me the encouraging word to speak last week. He said, there are those who have felt loss, and they've been asking me, when am I going to begin gaining? They have been praying to me. They've been saying, God, what's going on? I've lost this job, or I've lost this boyfriend or girlfriend, or I've lost this relationship, or I've lost this child. There's loss, loss, loss. You feel like you're just losing things. When are you going to start gaining things? And the Lord said, there are those that have asked him that in prayer. And he wants you to know the gains are coming. You will see the gains. Everything that has been removed, God allowed it to be removed for a reason. Does that mean he brings harm? No. But he allows things because it's for your good ultimately. And I made the joke at the Christmas bash, you know, anyone in here need to lose that boyfriend or girlfriend? Anyone need to lose 150 pounds? So here's the thing. A loss is not always a loss. But you need to know in your heart when you leave this place, and just like I said at the Christmas bash, you will see the gains. I don't know what the gain looks like. I don't know if it means a new job, a new girlfriend, just peace after the loss of a family member, maybe your health being restored if you've been in bad health. I don't know what it is, but the Lord wants you to know that the same way that Jesus was sent as a baby, this beautiful baby, he had to die so we could gain. He was a loss so we could gain. And his disciples said to him, this is not an Easter message, but it might end up being my Easter message, full one later. But his disciples couldn't understand. All they could feel was the loss. You're going to die? You're going to let them crucify you? You're God in the flesh. You can save yourself. Why are we going through this? You're supposed to take over the world. We're going to rule. We're going to take over evil with good. And he said, no, I'm supposed to die. And so here's the thing. They felt it as a loss. They thought Jesus dying was a loss. Is there something in your life that God has let die? And you have seen it as a loss. When really it's a gain. Because if Jesus was not born and then died, we would not have gained salvation. We would not have gained the relationship we have with him. We would not have gained hope and faith and truth. And so, your gains are coming. Trust him that your gains are coming. And you know what? I want to hear about the gains. I want to hear testimonies of the gains. I want to know. Keep track of them. You'll see in the back of the card, in the back of the seats, there's the cards that say, My Miracle. Take a card home and write down anything that God does. When you have a gain, I want you to write that miracle down. And we want to know about it. Put it in the offering bucket the next Sunday that you come back to church. Put it in there. We want to know what God's doing. Or tell us, you know, personally. Get a hold of the office during the week, the church office. And let Tammy know that you had a miracle. We want to know these things. But I'm telling you, gains are coming. And you know what? I'm going to speak this right now. This is a personal prophetic word for someone here, or maybe many. It's going to blow your mind. The gains that are coming are going to blow your mind. They're going to be more than what you think. You know how, let's say this for an example. You know how you lose a job? Let's say you lost a job, you were making $13 an hour. Okay, for instance. And you're thinking, man, gains would be just getting that $13 an hour job back. 14 would be nice, right? But when God blows your mind, that loss turns into $17 an hour, $18 an hour of a job replacing what you lost. So we have a tendency to just, can we just get back what we had? Can we have something equal to that, God? And he's like, wait a minute. That's not how I roll. I'm going to bless you and I'm going to blow your mind. And I am not going to just give you back equal. Anyone ever, you might not know this, but some of you in this room will know this. God usually doesn't take us backwards. He takes us forward. Don't beg for what happened over the year that you lost. Don't beg for it back. Because I'm telling you, there's something greater. And literally, as I'm standing here, I felt like the Lord said, there's those in this room, you need to know that your blessing is going to blow your mind. If you're in God's will. If what it is God's will, the blessing is going to blow your mind. And it's not equal to what you just lost. It's bigger. The gains are coming. Jesus was a gain. I'm sure his mother, Mary, thought it was a loss when he died on the cross because she knew that he was born of the Holy Spirit. And how amazing that would be to carry that, to be the birther of that. But he died to save the world. The gains are coming. Sometimes things have to be stripped away, and sometimes there has to be a death. Not, you know, we don't want all your family members dying off, but you know what I'm saying. There has to be a removal of somebody to replace them with the proper person. Get it? Get what I'm saying? There has to be a removal of that job that wasn't good or was a dead end so you can have a job that is going to take you somewhere and that you can feel like it's a blessing and not a cursing to you. So my prayer for you today is that you truly recognize the reason of the season, that Jesus Christ came and he was born for you. He was born of a virgin, and he is the Son of God. And he died for us so we could gain. And we're not to live this life like we're losers. We're not losers. We gain. Okay, I'm going to ask everybody to close their eyes. I always give opportunity. If you are here and you have never officially asked Jesus to come and live in your heart and ask him to be the savior of your life, if you have not done that, I always like to give opportunity for you to receive Christ. So with heads bowed and no one looking around, I'm going to ask you, if you're in this room, I want you in just a moment, not yet, to raise your hand, hold it up so I can see it. And then what's going to happen is everyone's just going to pray a simple prayer with you. And you're not going to be singled out, but we're going to pray a prayer with you to just receive Christ into your heart and life if you have never done that. So if you are here and you have never done that and you would like to ask Jesus into your heart this morning, just lift your hand up and hold it up. Give you one more moment. Anyone? Okay, awesome. Everyone here is most likely already done that. Amen. We're very thankful for that. So go ahead. You can look up. Let's go ahead and get ready to close in prayer. But the biggest thing I want you to take away from today is the honor and the glory of what Christ did and that this is all real. This is all real. And could you not feel it in the room today? I'll tell you, even if we have to do it by video, if we honor the Lord, he will show up. And he was here. I could feel his presence. He was pleased with how we were honoring him. So it was very hard for me to not stand and worship during the songs and just get all crazy up here. Start clapping and jumping, you know. So I was like, I have to keep my composure. It's Christmas service. Just kidding. I don't really ever need to keep my composure, but it's good every now and then to relax. So, but I think that's about it. The only other thing I was going to very quickly before I pray, remind you, please visit the resource table. Do not forget to visit the resource table. Angela is back there. She will help you with any questions you have for signing up or anything like that. But even our regulars, we need you guys to choose the group you're going to be attending, and you need to fill it in. Now, if something happens and we don't have enough signed up to fill both, then we'll do one group. But right now, we need to start getting those filled up so we know who's going where of our regulars, especially, and our main leaders. Is there any other announcements I'm forgetting? Other than, please, if you're able to, come. Oh, yeah. If you're able to, Christmas Eve, come between 5:30 and 7 to Eagletail Village, and we are going to be blessing the elderly there with caroling and candy canes, etc. So please come and be a part of that if you can. Also, we're going to go ahead and tear down. Normally, we could leave everything up, but they're going to wax the floors tomorrow. So we are allowed to just move everything into the music room. So we don't have to tear everything down and take it all out or anything like that. We can just set it in there. So even the tables, we're not going to tear down the tables, nothing. We're going to carry them in there just like that. But I want everybody to visit the tables back there first, please, before you do that. Also, if some of the main leaders, if you can let me know now or in the next couple of days, I know it's a lot. We're going into Christmas, and we're going to be taking the whole week off. You guys are going to go and have your time with your family. But if you know you're going to be here next Sunday service, please confirm with me as a leader. If you are, we're going to be trying to plan a leaders meeting, a post-Christmas bash leaders meeting right after Sunday service, if we can. If not, we will wait till the next week to make sure everyone's back in town. But I need to know if you're going to be able to be here next week for that. If not, that's fine. We'll put it off a week, but it'll only take about 20 minutes. We're just going to kind of talk about how things went and that kind of thing. So anyway, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you and we praise you. You are worthy in this place. You are worthy, Lord. We are going to honor you. We are going to do one last song, Joy to the World. And Lord, we are so thankful that you are our joy. And Lord, I just speak life and blessing over every person here. And I pray that they have a wonderful, blessed, and safe Christmas this week. In Jesus' name, amen.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare new. And heaven bendeth your sea. And heaven bendeth your sea. And your heaven and Thank you. Jesus. Walk in the dark, Lord. Walk in the dark, Lord. We keep the shining dark. We keep the shining dark. We keep the shining dark. We will say things. Joy to the world. We will say things. We will say things. We will say things. We choose our dreams. And amongst the nations prove the glories of His righteousness. And the days that He's loved, and the days that He's loved, and all His love are the
we will sing.